Less than 1,000 light-years from Earth, a massive red giant burns bright, sending its light through the universe. Or does it? Could this star be hiding a secret? One that proves we're not alone in the vast cosmos. Scientists are on the case investigating whether this distant star could provide evidence of alien life, and the discovery could change everything we know about our universe. As we develop more and more powerful telescopes, we're unlocking the secrets of the universe one star at a time. We're creating a catalog of stars that is staggering in size, well over a billion and counting. Most of them are so far away from Earth, it's likely impossible to travel to them. But we can only imagine the kind of planets that circle these far-off stars. Could they support life? Some may have tiny microbes that form the basic building blocks of life, but it's just as possible that there are entire civilizations even more advanced than our own out there, evolving and growing for millions of years. And that raises the question, what could they have already built? British physicist Freeman Dyson had a pretty bold idea. He suggested that once a species reaches a certain level of technological advancement, it could build a massive structure around its star, capturing nearly all of its energy to power its civilization. The civilization would surround the star with mirrors or solar panels, harnessing the energy and making the species completely self-sustaining. It sounds like something out of a sci-fi novel, and it is. But Dyson's theory, which came to be known as the Dyson Sphere, suggests that if such structures exist, they might already be out there waiting to be discovered. The idea of this star-harvesting machine actually comes from the 1937 sci-fi novel Star Maker by Olaf Stapledon. Stapledon was one of the earliest speculative sci-fi writers, imagining what might lie beyond our cosmos. In his novel, a man is mysteriously transported to a galaxy thousands of light-years away. There, he embarks on a cosmic journey exploring the nature of life and death, where he encounters an advanced species that had tamed the stars themselves. To audiences at the time, it was a mind-bending idea, something far beyond the realm of possibility. But now the question is, could it actually be possible? Dyson believed that with the right technology, building such a structure could be possible. He developed this thought experiment beyond what anyone expected and became known for his Dyson series, a collection of complex theoretical scientific concepts with each one partnered with a Feynman drawing showing how the physics would work. But none of his theories captured the imagination of the public quite like the Dyson Sphere, a self-sustaining environment that would have an energy source that could last for millions of years. In today's world, tech billionaires would scramble to be the first to create something that could shape the future of humanity. But could someone, or something, have already built a Dyson Sphere? Dyson developed his theory, detailing the technology that would be needed to create such a massive device. He described how the sphere would emit excess heat as infrared radiation, creating a unique heat signature. This could then be used to track them, but would also present a bigger problem. If a hostile alien civilization picked up on that heat signature, it could pose a serious threat to the advanced planet. But what about a peaceful civilization that wanted to make contact instead? Could these heat signatures be a clue to the existence of extraterrestrial life? Some scientists think they may have already found a clue. When Dyson first explained his theory, scientists laughed, telling him to go back to his more credible concepts that made him a candidate for the Nobel Prize, although he never won. But some found his theories intriguing, especially the idea that a search for unusual heat signatures could be the key to discovering extraterrestrial life. Dyson's concepts even appeared in Star Trek, but Dyson kept his focus on science. He believed it would be easier to discover alien technology than to directly contact alien life. Dyson died in 2020, but his concepts are still going strong. When Dyson first popularized his theory, it was entirely speculative. We had just landed on the moon, and studying distant stars and planets was still a major challenge. But as technology advanced with more powerful telescopes and the establishment of the SETI Institute, the search for extraterrestrial life became a serious scientific pursuit. Out of all the stars in the observable universe, the Milky Way alone contains over a billion, making it the most practical place to start looking. Scientists have narrowed down their focus, and out of the 5 million stars under observation, they're paying close attention to just 7. In May 2024, the monthly notices of the Royal Astronomical Society published a report from a group of astronomers searching for alien life and Dyson spheres. While this publication usually wouldn't publish anything resembling a UFO hunt, These scientists had a solid scientific approach based on Dyson's theory that an infrared heat signature could reveal advanced life forms. Their search spanned huge areas of space and they ruled out countless candidates, but there were seven they simply could not rule out, and those seven all had some mysteries in common. All seven stars are located less than 1,000 light-years from Earth. They were identified from a huge sample of all the detectable stars in the Milky Way, then filtered using a complex algorithm to eliminate data contamination. But even after all of this, these seven stars still had an unusual amount of infrared heat, something that couldn't be explained by any natural sources. Like most stars, they likely have satellites orbiting them, but our telescopes aren't advanced enough to reveal what those planets look like. So, have we found our first Dyson spheres? It's possible, but there are some possible explanations. The universe is filled with infrared heat, which could cause a false positive. For example, a distant galaxy in the background could be overlapping with the star, interfering with the telescope's results. Or the stars could be newly formed and surrounded by hot debris as the galaxy's bodies continue to form. It could even be emanating from another source completely, but giant star spheres feeding a planet with energy might not be the most likely scenario. It is definitely the most exciting one, though. Two of the most powerful space telescopes, NASA's Wide Field Infrared Survey Explorer, or WISE, and Gaia from the European Space Agency, combed the sky in an elaborate operation. Once they had eliminated the other 5 million or so stars, they were able to collect some more data on the ones that remained as candidates. Interestingly, they were all red dwarf stars, the most common in our galaxy. While they aren't as big or as powerful as our Sun, red dwarfs could sustain life under the right conditions. But these stars aren't easy to see, so this makes following up on them more difficult. But now that we have seven locations, the process of zeroing in on them begins. Scientists have gathered as much information as they can from the seven mystery stars, but many questions still remain. It's not clear if any of them have planets surrounding them. While most stars attract satellites of some kind, not all of them develop into planets. It might just be that our telescopes haven't been able to observe them yet. Red dwarfs are seen as hospitable to life. Colder planets may have better conditions for creating life than those near hotter stars. And from the many, many red dwarfs that the study examined, a large number do have planets. And those planets would be the key to a Dyson sphere. The Dyson sphere requires a number of factors to work together. First, a planet would have to form around a star capable of sustaining life. Then that life would have to evolve under the right conditions to develop into an advanced civilization. And then building the Dyson sphere would be a long-term project, maybe taking a number of centuries to complete. But even if one was built, would we even know what it looks like? These massive objects would be unlike anything we've seen, and discovering one would mean coming into contact with a civilization far beyond ours, which means it's time to use the most powerful tool we have. A research team in Italy has been mapping the Milky Way, identifying 53 possible anomalies, stars with unusual energy signatures, but that doesn't mean that all of them are Dyson sphere candidates. It's likely these research groups will link up and compare data to eliminate as many sources as they can before deciding on what to do next. Investigating in space is a complex and long-term prospect, and that calls for the best. And that's where the James Webb Space Telescope comes in. It is the most advanced space telescope to ever place eyes on the cosmos, and it's likely to be part of the next part of the search. And space is constantly evolving. There are numerous explanations for unusual energy in space, and things can change long before we ever have a chance to react. The Pillars of Creation, a stunning formation of interstellar gas and dust in the Eagle Nebula, was captured on the Hubble Space Telescope in 1995. But later analysis indicated that it had likely been destroyed long ago in a supernova. Due to the vast distances and the speed at which light travels, we won't see the destruction from Earth for another 1,000 years. What we can see is a ghost of a space formation that doesn't exist. So if we were to discover the existence of Dyson spheres around these stars, the questions would be just beginning. For one thing, these spheres would be absolutely massive. Even though a red dwarf is smaller than our Sun, it's estimated that a Dyson sphere would require more raw material than everything on Earth. We would be looking at a civilization with unbelievable technological capabilities, one that might see us the same way we would look at a fly buzzing around our heads when we're trying to build a doghouse. Then there's the question of how to contact them. We've sent probes into deep space before, but nowhere near as far as these stars. It would take hundreds of light years to investigate the closest one. But scientists are always looking for the next great discovery, so they won't let that stop them. The next step is to get the James Webb Space Telescope in on the deal and take a closer look at these seven stars. The odds are several will turn out to be false positives, created by phenomena such as debris disks, large clouds of space dust left behind by collisions. These are often called hot dogs, or hot dust-obscured galaxies, and they can produce false positives that frustrate astronomers. But if there is one that indicates the possibility of a highly advanced civilization, it could be the biggest scientific discovery in the history of humanity. So, what would it take? First, we would need an even more powerful space telescope that could provide clear images of not only the star, but any planet surrounding it. We would need even more advanced technology capable of sending probes or signals into the furthest reaches of the Milky Way. And we would need the greatest minds on Earth working together. If we do make contact with alien life, we need to present the best of humanity. And let's hope first contact doesn't happen during an election year. Want to learn more about some of the strangest locations in the known universe? Check out Terrifying Planets That Will Literally Tear You to Pieces, or watch this video instead.